Dear students, from today we are going to start our next modules, a series of modules on Microsoft PowerPoint. So Microsoft PowerPoint is a kind of software that helps you to make the presentations. So first of all, we should understand that why we want to make the presentations. So this can be understood by the presentations which we are having at the moment, and you are trying to learn from this presentation. So the alternative method could be that I write all of the things on one Word document, and then I face the tablet, and then I start reading those text, or I distribute all of the text to all of the students and they can read at home, and that's it, and there is no presentation. So then your learning might not be so strong, because in the presentation we have very small points which are written in the text, and then those points are explained in details. Then we can add some graphics, we can add some pictures, we add some live interaction of the professor in that particular slides. So such kind of things are not possible on a document. And then in the presentation, different content is coming flying from somewhere and adjusting in the slide. So you can create some kind of visualization or concepts that are really very easier to understand. And in the presentations, always remember that there is a rule of 6 by 6. So which means that in your presentation, there should not be more than 6 points, and each point should not be more than 6 words. However, if you require, then you can add few more words to your presentation to make it more understandable. But this is the rule, and you should try to follow to make an impressive presentations. And the next thing is that the font in your presentation should be very high. So for example, at least you should go with 26 font, so that your presentation is really readable. But if there are many small things in your presentation, even then the smallest possible font should be 18 or above 18. So in today's module, I will show you the Microsoft PowerPoint, and we will see that what is the layout of that main PowerPoint window, and what are the resemblances with Microsoft Word, which we have learned in the previous module. So let's start the practical. So I have Microsoft Word installed on my computer, and this comes with the same Microsoft Office 2013. I clicked on new. So there are many different options available in new. So let's, at the start, let's go with the simplest option. So here you can see that this is the main slide on which you can add whatever you want. And these are different placeholders. So you can add some text over here, for example, ITC, and some subtitle at view, right? So we have discussed this slide, and we have seen that the placeholder is available over here with this dotted line where you can add whatever you want. And we will be seeing in the next modules that we can add some other placeholders which can store pictures, images, animations, etc. And let's see that what are the similarities and resemblances with Microsoft Word, which we have learned. So see, in the file, all of the options are the same as in Microsoft Word, more or less. Then in the home, you can see the clipboard. The slide is new, but font is same. So for example, if you click on it, so this has we have learned in Microsoft Word. This paragraph we have learned in Microsoft Word. You have seen the bullets and numbering and spaces, etc. Then drawing and editing is a little bit different. Then in insert, we have tables, images. So shapes, smart art, charts. So almost all of the things which we have learned in our previous Microsoft Word are available over here. So in this type of presentations and modules, we will be more focusing on new things which are newly added in this. For example, in Home Ribbon, in the next module, we will be focusing on slides. Then in transition and animation, more specifically, to learn that what is actually possible, and of course the design, that what is actually possible to make an impressive presentation using this particular software. So let's conclude today's module. We have learned that why we need the presentations and what the work are there which cannot be done in simple Microsoft Word. And we have seen the differences between document and presentation. We have seen the layout of main PowerPoint window. And we have seen that there are certain similarities. In fact, there are many, many similarities with the options of ribbons and groups available on the top as with the Microsoft Word, which we have already studied. So in the next module, we will start studying more Microsoft PowerPoint.